Thank you. going to share my experience about how I felt in the school. I'm studying in this school from past 4 years. The first day I came into the school, I was so excited to see my colorful classroom and my new friends. We learned karate, which helps us to protect ourselves. I learned so many activities like drawing, art and craft, and music, which help us to refresh our mind. We all are involved in various projects of all subjects where we learn things out of the syllabus. I like to participate in assembly every day, where we get a chance to say few words in front of the whole school, like thought of the day, bhajans, articles, and news. I like to thank my class teacher, from whom I learned to be disciplined in class. I'm very happy to share my experience in front of you all. It's a pleasure to be in Sanford. It is a great pleasure for me to be a Sanfordian. Thank you.
Our school has a library where we find storybooks and various case magazines, which helps us to increase our knowledge. Our school campus has swimming pool, computer lab, and an auditorium. Swimming makes our body and we are thankful to our principal who has provided all these facilities. Now I'd like to tell you about greenery in our school. Our school premises have plenty of bushes which make our mind active. Our physical directors help us in doing various physical activities. I like all my subject teachers who are the pillars of Sanford. They not only teach us the subject, they teach us how to behave, manners, and discipline, and punctuality. I thank all of them from the bottom of my heart. Thank you all for giving me such a great opportunity to tell about our school. Thank you.
Respected dignitaries, dear teachers, and all my dear most Sanfordians, a very warm welcome to this annual day. I am a student of Sanford School. I take this opportune moment to voice my thoughts and share my experiences. I am so glad that I was and am a part of this school. When I studied here, I never wanted to miss the school, as we had great fun and good education here. As you can see, we have a beautiful campus, a big playground, AC and digital classrooms, and a swimming pool as well. Though we have all the modern technology, importance is given to tradition and culture. We have good ambience and experienced teachers who impart good education and also moral values to kids. We see many child prodigies nowadays. I can see that truly schools give us a good platform to showcase our talents. Right from lower classes, students are trained in such a way that they can easily participate in various curricular and extracurricular activities. You create ease and self-confidence. Don't you think I'm an example for this? Along with studies, our school takes kids to field trips, picnics, and to places where we can learn new concepts and explore new things. We have a very good collection of books in our library. As we all know, a healthy mind in a healthy body. The students here are trained to be fit physically and mentally. We have a healthy and hygienic environment here. The management is taking good care to see that are comfortable and also disciplined. I wish and hope that Sanford is going to expand its horizons and become one of the top schools in the city. I wish all my juniors the very best in the coming days and a happy childhood. I thank one and all and wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year in advance.
I request our principal ma'am, Mrs. Vidya Mishra, to say a few words. Kindly give her a warm welcome.
Ladies and gentlemen, my friends, my dear children, parents, teachers, director sir, principal madam, all the dignitaries on the stage and off the stage, I welcome you all to the most exciting and historic event, our 5th annual celebrations. I'm feeling very proud and very happy today because we have reached a very important milestone. We have completed 5 successful years. And in 5 years, we have sorted out almost all the small and big problems we had. Initially, when we started school, things were not in place that much. But now, I can confidently boast that we have almost everything, best of best facilities, AC classrooms, swimming pool, as my children were already saying, so I need not repeat the same. Transportation issues are solved completely, I hope. With this backup of a very good past, with all the small highs and lows we have done, all the problems are sorted, and we look forward to a very bright future. We have again, Parikar sir will announce that, we have again taken a very big land in Kasipalli, where we broke the new branch. So now our final dream of KG to PG will be happening. Thank you. So, our biggest asset so far has always been the best of my teachers and a very cooperative management. Anything we want, almost here or there we got it. And in fact, we got more than what we wanted, mostly. And my brilliant children, I can't say that there's a single dull in my school. Not a single dull. Can any of you say that a child is dull? Anyone? Practically no. All children are very special, intelligent in their own ways. Some are very good in academics, some are good in sports, some are good in both. And some, they are not interested at the moment, but sometimes down the line they'll be interested too. So many people have put their faith in us, have trusted us, and has been involved in the process, very actively guiding us, helping us wherever I need your help. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart, and thank you all for your ever coming up support. While we have gathered here to celebrate our splendid achievements during the year 2017-18, this is also the way to reaffirm our roles and responsibilities and to pledge that there will be continuous improvements in years to come. The education system that we are following this time, I think it is pretty old. Do you agree? Do you think so? Still, after so many years, we are learning the same pattern, same things, that our children are learning the same thing that we learned. Kind of, yes. Certain things will not, sure. Certain things will not change for sure, I accept. But the speed, the rate at which things are growing, people are becoming global. Now our competition is no more at a local level. 25 years back, or 20 years back, when I was in school, our competition was within the school, at max inter-school. Now, go online, all Olympiads, all possible international examinations are available. So you are competing with international children. If you want, just now, Vijay Madam was showing me a video of one of our old children. She was with us, Dia, and she was participating in an international thing, and she got selected for from a school level she was participating, and now she got selected for an international show-up. So that is the thing. We are no more local at all. So there is no limits, right? Today, it is no more a time for by-hearting things. That day has gone. Earlier, it used to be that person who remembers the maximum thing is the intelligent person. No? Encyclopedia, we call a person. Because that person remembers everything. But now, it's not about that. Any question you have in your mind, what do you do? Simply Google it. No? Simply Google it. All you need to know is to ask the right question. You ask the right question and you get the answer. As simple as that. I don't find any much difference between two people, aged 30 and aged 15. 30 and 15. You know? Or suppose if I put myself over here, me and you just saw Girishma or Naina or Costco, both of us are almost equal in terms of knowledge, because Girishma plus Google is equal to Vidya Mishra. No, Our work as parents, as teachers, our work is only to give them a safe, conducive environment and limit the intake. So many things are available, but we have to limit it as to what we can give and what we should not. Right? And allow children to decide. Discuss with them. This is something I think we Indian parents need to still develop. We don't, you know, we think that I'm a mother, so I decide. Yeah, give them choices. If you give them choices, they will, you know, think more practically. For example, you go with your child to a mall, and your child will keep saying, Nana, I want that. Mama, I want that. It happens. And the child goes on and on and on with that. So before you go, make a strategy. Maybe you have 500 rupees. Whatever you want, buy from them. This is practical learning. This is practical decision making. And then you see the difference with your child. Child will go. He wants things. He'll come up with a thing. Nana, what is the cost? No? Tell them. Find a discount. See the variety. They will become involved in it. Instead of buying their things, allow them to, you know, to see. Buying things and coming to the material aspect, that is one thing. Second important thing that we should teach our children is control and consumption. How much to consume? How much do you need? Dresses, any number of dresses is there. Anybody's house full of dresses, difficult time to find out the school uniform from that. But it happens or not happens. Green t-shirt. Pencils, stationery, full, your house is full of that. But there is no pencil in the bag. Children don't come with correct stationery to school. And house is flooded with that. You are irritated with that. No? Why this happens? Because we have flooded them with what they want or what they don't want. Right? So they don't value things. Now, in last 5 years, as I'm here in Sanford, I have seen a lot of things here, and it's my personal observation. I have seen that parents who have little less money, their children are doing very well. It's surprising. The parents who have little less resources, their children are doing good. They always have a color pencil in their bag, a small crayon box. They are comparatively better dressed, less casual. Why do you think this happens? Do you also agree with me? Do you feel that? That when there is abundance of things, children won't value stuff? Correct? So here is what I'm trying to say. That control things. Control the consumption. The speed with which, you know, when we earlier we used to take grocery from a kirana shop, it was a limited thing. Maybe 2-3 jholas, bags, you got everything you wanted. And now, I think one trolley is also not enough. And now, because trolley is there, you don't have to carry the stuff. You keep putting stuff. You keep getting abundant stuff, and still you don't have things at the right moment. If we, coming back to the education stuff, that for education, we keep thinking that, you know, education is books. What you read, math, science, English, only that one. Education is not that. Education has a bigger perspective than that. Much bigger. Which we don't realize. And that is why, at times, parents come to me. Well, they get their child to me, that please hold him. Now, what should I scold the child? How I feel like send the child out and scold you better. Because the environment that we have created is not conducive for learning. Overthrowing things on them. And education, they will study. All children will study. When they need the reason to study. If they understand that they need to know maths, so that they can find out the percentage of discount, so that they can buy their stuff, they find the reason, they get interested in maths. Right? English, you want to voice your opinion? You need to speak? You want me to listen to you? Speak correctly. Right? That is how English is important. Science. How
books to almost 50%. I want to reduce.
Thank you. Yes.
And that is going to be a very big decision. But cutting off books does not mean cutting off education. That is why I'm elaborating on education so much today. Because if I cut down on books, our involvement has to increase. Our writing work has to reduce. Our reading and our comprehension, that has to increase. Children should be encouraged to read. Yeah? They should find interest. So here, I need your involvement to the maximum. Stop the traditional way. Not required. I'll give you an example of difference between the traditional and new way. Suppose I ask you, A for? What do you say? Answer? A for?
Children, learn from the Sanford.
surrounding. So be very particular about the kind of surrounding we are creating around them, at home and in school. It's our responsibility. If a child, don't criticize your child very often. If a child is often criticized, they learn how to condemn others. So control your emotions when you are dealing with a child. If a child is often praised, that again leads to bigger difficulties. So control your behavior and the child goes right. Never speak badly to a child. This is something we tend to ignore. We take it for granted that, okay, we are parents, or we can be rough with a child. No. Absolutely no. You should never be rough to a child. Do you think if somebody is rough with you, will you listen to that person? I'm telling the same to parents. Always check. Whenever you are angry, be thoughtful of the words you are telling them. And raising hands, absolutely, just leave it outside your door. That is how not even animals will behave. Unfortunately, in my school, I have some parents, or some children, because they come and tell something close to us. There are some children who are scared of their parents. To the extent, they tell me, ma'am, you give me any punishment, but don't call my parents. That is really sad. If that is the situation, it's very sad. And are so intelligent that when they do something wrong, I'm about punished. And my punishment is, my favorite punishment is, I will not do it again, right, 50 times. My most favorite punishment. Having that, some intelligent children will come for negotiation. Can I just say sorry and go? Can I write 10 times? So, this is the way, you know, a soft punishment, or maybe, you know, if you want to punish, because it happens, that situation comes. Give them some words, like, you know, broom the house, clean their clothes, or fix the problem you have broken, something like that. Punishment should always be constructive. And words should always be very careful. Very careful. We are going to head to a more international approach towards teaching. So I want your involvement at all stages, and particularly in, you know, disciplining the children, getting their behavior right, making them interested in studies. We have lots of competitions, drawing competition, they are making competition, dance, music, elocution, fancy dress, storytelling, spelling competition, endless competitions we have. Quizzes and drills, national and international news, thought of the day, these are very much part of our everyday assembly curriculum. Designed to develop our students to be dynamic, future-ready individuals who not only live up to the school's value of respect for self-advancement. We believe that these sports-related activities not only will keep body fit, they also help us build character as students develop a sense of ruggedness, resilience, and teamwork. Things around us are changing very fast. We cannot anticipate the change. Technology is changing, mindset is changing, environment, morality, circumstances, temperature, everything is changing. The only thing constant is change. So the only way to adapt to this change is be very much part of it. Any speech